The Rainbow Serpent by Dick Rupsey. Far off in dreamtime, there were only people, no animals or birds, no trees or bushes, no hills or mountains. The country was all flat. Griela, the great rainbow serpent, stood and set off to look for his own tribe. He traveled across Australia from south to north. He reached Cape York, where he stopped and made a big red mountain called Narrabulgan. He listened on the wind and heard only voices speaking strange languages. This is not my country. The people here speak a different tongue. I must look further for my own people. Griela left Narrabulgan, and his body made a deep gorge where he came down. He traveled north, stopping every evening to listen on the wind for his own people. He traveled for many days, and his tracks made the creeks and the rivers as he journeyed north. His next resting place was at Fairview, where he made Lily Lagoon called Minilinka. Griela turned his great body round and round, but the ground was too hard to make it deep. One day he heard singing on the wind. He heard, "Those are my people singing," said Griela. "They are holding a big burra." He traveled north, the singing coming louder and louder. At the meeting place of the two rivers, Griela found his own people. They were dancing and singing. He crawled up quietly and lay in hiding to watch them. He watched them for a long time. Then he came out, was welcomed by his own people. He told them, "Your men not dancing properly, and you are not dressing properly. Watch me, and I will show you the correct way." Griela showed the men how to fit a lamp of beeswax on the back of their heads and use feathers to make a raid address. He dressed them with pandanus armbands and placed white bones through the noses. Then he taught them to dance, and they copied him until they were tired. A big storm was gathering, so all the people built humpies for shelter. Two young men, the Pilpil or Rainbow Lorikeet brothers, come running in looking for shelter, but no one had room. They asked the grandmother, the Star Woman, but she said, "I have too many dogs. I can't help you, boys." The Pilpil boys went Griela and found him snoring his campy. Then the boys call out. He yawned. And said, "I have no room for you." The rain came heavier, and the boys ran all about the camp looking for shelter, but no one would help them. The boys went back to Griel and called out that the rain was heavy. Griel said, "All right, you wait. I will make my humpy bigger." He opened it, his mouth wider, right up to the roof, and said, "All right, you can come in now." The Pilpul brothers ran into Griel's mouth, and he swallowed them. Then he began worrying about what his people would do, and they found the boys were missing. He decided to travel north to Burbunru, the only great natural mountain in the land. Next morning, the people asked each other who had given the shelter to the Pilpul boys. They found the boys were gone and saw the track of Griela and knew he had swallowed them. The man took spears and followed after Griela. Griela traveled toward distant Burmunru, the mighty mountain which towered far up into the sky. When he reached the cliff, around its base, Griela crawled up there. He coiled up for his sleep with the Pilpul boys inside. The people followed Griela to the steep base of Burbunru. The men tried to climb the cliff. Emu, turkey, brolga, tortoise, possum, barramundi, they all tried, but keep falling down again. The Wangu, or three Gawaina brothers, came along. Grinja, the emu, said to them, "We cannot climb this steep mountain." The Wangu said, "We will climb up to the rescue of the Pilpul boys." They each made a knife from cord and began to climb the mountain. The Wangu brothers climbed for days and nights. And on reaching the top, found Griela fast asleep and snoring. They crept up to him. An elder brother said, "We will cut him open. You start down there, and I will start here." They cut until they reached the Pilpul boys, who had changed into beautiful parrots with all the color of the rainbow serpent. The Wangu said, "You can come out. You are now rainbow lorikeet with wings and can fly away." The Pilpul birds flew away. The Wangu brothers ran down the mountain. Griela snored on until a cold wind blew through his empty stomach and wake him. He said, "Something is wrong with me," and looked about and saw where he had been cut and his dinner stole. Griela became angry and worked himself into a great rage. He began to thrash about in fury, his long red tongue flashing like lightning. And the great mountain shook and thundered as Griela tore it apart in his anger. He hauled part of a mountain all over the country to form the hills and mountains of today. All the people were terrified of the thunder on the mountain as Griela knocked it to pieces. Some of them were killed by flying stones. Others ran away to hide, turning themselves into all the kind of animals, birds, insect, and plant life that live in the country today. That is how it all happened back in dreamtime, when Griela's anger was spent there were only small hills, remaining of the great mountain, Brubunru. He went down and disappeared into the sea, where he remained to this day. Now the remaining people have to look after all the animals, all the living things, which were men and women in the beginning. But who were too afraid of old Griela to remind Hesa people? The shooting star rushing across the sky at night. He's the eye of a Griela, watching everybody. I'm